Shalom, shalom, family, shalom. All praises to the Most High Power and His Son, Yahweh Shai. And this is the day I am glad and I will rejoice in this day that you made, Father, and I'm very thankful for it because you made it, and I'm thankful. No matter what happens, I am grateful for this day. And I'm praying for my brothers and sisters scattered throughout the four corners of the earth. The brothers in travel, brothers in sickness, brothers and sisters in sickness, I send a prayer up to the Most High that He heals your body, as only He can do. And that's all we can do is pray that they be healed. But I want to share some more information very important information. And I want to start off in the book of Proverbs, okay? Chapter 1. I want to read it to you. It says that the Proverbs of Solomon, the son of David, king of Israel, to know wisdom and instruction, to perceive the words of understanding, to receive the instruction of wisdom, justice, and judgment, and equity, to give subtlety to the simple, to the young man knowledge and discretion. A wise man will hear and will increase learning, and a man of understanding shall attain unto wise counsel. To understand the proverb and the interpretation, the words of the wise and their dark sayings. The Bible itself is the only wisdom on the earth is in this Bible. Okay, that's why that's what that's talking about. The wisdom in our people, they say they love the Lord, they love Jesus and all of that, but they don't read these things that are in this Bible. They don't follow it. So, let me read. It says 7. The fear of Yahweh, or the Lord, is the beginning of knowledge. The fear of Yahweh is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction. My son, hear the instruction of thy father and forsake not the law of thy mother. Okay? Now, the law is throughout this whole book, Old Testament, New Testament. Okay, so there's no getting around it. No matter what people say about the laws are done away with, he fulfilled the law. You know, that's not true. Not true at all. And let's see something here. Okay. Now, let's see. And listen, this is in Proverbs 1 and verse 24. Because I have called and ye refused, I have stretched out my hand and no man regarded. But ye have set at naught all my counsel and would none of my reproof. In other words, y'all don't want to hear this book. You don't want to hear the gospel, the true gospel in this book. Who it's for, who it's about. It's about a people. It's for a people. It's the people that the Most High chose. And everybody He did not choose. Okay? Now listen to this. But ye have set at naught all my counsel and would none of my reproof. Proof, number 26. Now, this is what the Most High said. I also will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear cometh. Now, you gotta think about that. Think about when your fear coming. When them bullets is coming through your window or your house or somebody shooting at you or death is knocking at your door. This is what the Most High said. He said, I also will laugh at your calamity. Whatever it may be, He's going to laugh at it. I will mock when your fear coming. 27, when your fear cometh as desolation and your destruction cometh as a whirlwind, when distress and anguish cometh upon you, then shall they call upon me, but I will not answer. This is the Most High. This is God. He's saying, because you're a wicked people, you don't want to follow what He's telling you to do. There's instruction. This is why this is called the Book of the Law. There's a certain way that our people are supposed to live, and we don't do it, okay? Because we're listening to somebody else telling us how to live, okay? Said, for that they hated knowledge and did not choose the fear of the Lord. See, we have to fear the Lord. In order to get the understanding, you have to fear Him first. Most people say they fear God. They really don't fear Him, because if you did, you would do the commandments, okay? They would none of my counsel. They despise all my reproof. Now I'm going to go over here again, Proverbs 3. My son, forget not my law, but let thine heart keep my commandments. For length of days and long life and peace shall they add to thee. Okay? Listen, the laws, this is how you live according to the laws. And what they're telling you now is, oh, you don't have to do that. We're not in that no more. Well, what are we in? What are we? Look at us as a people. Look, what are we in? We're on the bottom. Okay. We're locked up. Nobody can tell us nothing. We won't listen to nobody. We are lawless people. The same spirits that's here today were the same spirits that was back there with Moses. Okay. The same spirits. Okay. So, now, let me see, what else? Let's see. Chapter 4. Hear ye, children, the instruction of a father, and attend to no understanding. For I give you good doctrine, forsake ye not my law. Everything in this book is telling you how. And when you go in Deuteronomy, it tells you to choose life or choose death. There's death. So what happens when you choose not to follow the laws and to follow something else, you choose death. And I want y'all to look around, look on the news, go on YouTube. It's a whole lot of death going on. All death is ordained by the Most High. Okay? All death is, it's not, because what do you guys, you know, you hear people say, oh, the devil is busy. The devil, the devil. Devil ain't busy. He is busy, but he ain't. He don't have the. How can I say it? He don't have the final say. Let's put it like that. All right, and let's see here. Chapter 6, verse 23. For the commandment is a lamp, and the law is light, and reproofs of instruction are the way of life. Now, what I want to do is, let's see here. I'm going to go over to, let's go over to John right quick, because I want to show you something. Let's see here. Now, this is in the New Testament, right? And they say you ain't in the Old Testament. Okay. Hold on, let's get it. I want to make sure I get the right thing, because I want to make sure you hear this. This is 1 John chapter 2. And hereby we do know that we know him if we keep his commandments. This is in the New Testament. He that said, now this is for you people who think you really know the Most High. He that saith, I know him. I love Jesus. I'm married to Jesus. That's what, this is what you hear people saying. They married to Jesus. Nothing but the blood, nothing but the blood. Whole glory, all of these things. He that saith, I know him, and keepeth not his commandments, is a liar, and the truth is not in him. That's 1 John chapter 2, verse 3 and 4. Okay? Now let me see. Hold on. Let me see if there's something else out here. And then I wanted to see what sin, the sin is what separates us from the Most High. For one, we know that. Okay? Now, I'm going to go to why I said that. I'm sorry, because sin, you ask people, what is sin? Some people will say, they'll say different things. But everything, the Bible answers everything. Okay? I'm going to go to it. 1 John chapter 3, verse 4. Whosoever committeth sin transgresseth also the law. For sin is the transgression of the law. Okay, so that's what your sin is. Now, the law was only given to a certain people. Everybody on the earth didn't get the law. That takes you back to Deuteronomy 1. Moses was talking only to the children of Israel. They're the only people on the earth through bloodline that have the law and are supposed to be keeping those commandments. Although we can't keep all everything because we are yet this day in our captivity. Now, okay, and now 1 John 5. Whosoever believeth that Yahweh, I'll just read it like it's written, Jesus is the Christ, is born of God, And everyone that loveth him that begat loveth him also that is begotten of him. By this we know that we love the children of God, when we love God and keep his commandments. That's how you show God you love him. You can't reach up into heaven and hug him and love him and all that other stuff. You keep his commandments by not polluting the Sabbath, by following it, by doing all his Sabbaths. Because truth be told, only the remnant is keeping the commandments. The world doesn't, they don't want to follow what the scripture says to do. It's telling you right here. Okay? For this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments. And his commandments are not grievous. So, it's in the scriptures. I'm reading it to you. Now, John, I'm going to go into 2 John 1 and 6. And this is love. Now, I'm going to read to you what love is according to the Bible. Not according to my opinion or some preacher's opinion, anybody else. And you can go back and read this yourself. And this is love, that we walk after his commandments. This is the commandment, that as ye have heard from the beginning, ye should walk in it.